Hi guys, my name is Samad. I'm going to tell you how we can work with Microsoft project to create a Gantt chart. In fact, in this video I'm going to show you how to create a Gantt chart for your research project. Gantt chart is a great way to get a bird's eye view for the entire project. To make your project Gantt chart, you need a list of tasks. What kind of activities you need to do for this research project? Best to list all of your tasks in order that need to be done, so your project will be organized and it will be easy to read as well. So I've already opened a blank project using the Microsoft project, a new version of Microsoft project, and I've added a few tasks for my project. I will do a few more so you can see the process how to do it by yourself. Just click in a task field like here. For example, you can say interpretation of qualitative data analysis, for example, and then that's the name. So you've typed in the name of the task. If you have tasks that are related to each other, it might be a good idea if you group them together. So like group them as subtasks. To do that, you need to just highlight the tasks that are related to each other and click the right intent button in the ribbon. So you can click on some of them. For example, you say data collection, data analysis, and then maybe this one, for example, is related to the report. So just this one, and then you push this button, and you can see this is a subtask of this draft analysis report. If there is anything else a part of that, for example, maybe you can change this one saying data analysis 2. So this is again a part of this, both of them. So maybe you can say control data analysis and then again use that one. So both of them are going to be a part of this specific task. So the same thing I've done here. So you can see there are a couple of subtasks for research possible topics, so all of them are related to your topic selection. Okay, so you don't have to use subtasks, but they can be useful and helpful and allow you to collapse sections down to see main tasks all together. For example, like that, then you can see how many main tasks do you have, and this will be applied on the duration here as well. You can see the bar charts actually will be gone if you do that. Okay, so now click on the finish or start date. For example, here for the interpretation, if you want to start the interpretation of your data, you need to see where the data collection will be finished, for example, or the data analysis will be finished. This is much more relevant, so you just copy this and then paste in this field. So you can see, okay, this figure here, you can see the date is going to be, for example, 16th of June. So that's your start date. You need to say how many days is going to be the duration of this task. Maybe 7 days, 1 week. Sorry, here, 7 days. So when you say seven, then the finish time will be automatically calculated. So you will have the finish time here. Okay, so now is a good time to add some milestones. Milestones are great ways to make sure your project is running on time. Okay, one way to do that is the duration day. You use the duration day and make it 0. So for example, if you have the submission day, maybe here we can find one of those here. Submission, yeah, this one, abstract. The submission day is, for example, if you say my submission day is 2 days actually here, then you have a bar here, you can see the bar here. But if you say the duration should be zero, then you turn actually this activity to a milestone, and then you need to make a decision. This milestone is linked to what activity or what kind of activities or series of activities or tasks should be done before this milestone. You can link them to this. For example, first of all, because I already linked, so I just unlinked and then say you press this button, and then you link these two activities together. When I press this button, you can see the bar in front of that, this bar, and also this dot will be connected. So just use this and you can see both of them are connected to each other. So it means this activity or a series of activities like this should be done, because all of them are linked to this milestone. So that's all, and this would be enough for you to know about how to use Microsoft Project to create your Gantt chart. But if you don't have access to Microsoft Project, you can use Excel, and Excel has enough functions to create a Gantt chart for your research project. Thank you for watching this video.